This is actually quite a strange arrangement you see at the back of the throat here, because the food has actually had to cross over the airstream. So when you swallow, the food has to pass by your windpipe to get down to the esophagus. And this is really just an accident of history. We evolved from a type of fish which had its swim bladder or air sac in front of its gut. So when the fish then developed legs and stood up, it turns out that our lungs are now in front of our esophagus. So in order to make sure that the food actually gets into the right tube, we have this little trap door called the epiglottis. And part of the machinery of the pharynx is that when you swallow, the epiglottis automatically closes. Of course, sometimes it doesn't get it quite right, and a bit of particle of food or some fluid actually gets into the top of the windpipe, and that's when we choke. And we have a reflex there then to cough that out of the windpipe and to make sure that the food hasn't gone down and blocked our lungs.
So I demonstrate this here. The piece of food comes out of the mouth, to the back of the mouth, and now it approaches the epiglottis. The windpipe closes. It goes here. When a little bit might go in here, we have the coughing. It would go back. But now this time it closes. Wonderful. Here it goes its way down to the esophagus, down here into the stomach.